These are notes on observing biology from different scales. And we're going to explain the scales to you, but I just wanted to say first that these notes come from a set of notes we normally give in our other semester's worth of work. So that's why they might seem a little choppy, just because we've kind of cut and pasted them so that you're only watching the stuff you need right now.
Let's start here. Let's start with the macroscopic. Macroscopic essentially means what we can see. Okay, and macroscopic tends to be in this green region here, and here is 1 meter, okay? So that would be 10 to the zero, so this is a meter, okay? And then if you know, like, here would be a decimeter, that's 1/10 of a meter. A centimeter is right here. A lot of you guys are familiar with centimeters. Put in a little cm here. That's 1/100th of a meter. Or the reverse of looking at that is, so you understand that 10 to the negative 2 is 1/100th. Another way of saying that is there's 100 centimeters, cent meaning 100, that's why I talk about 100 cents in a dollar. There's 100 centimeters in 1 meter. Or each centimeter is 1/100th of a meter. And then we get millimeters, 1/1000th of a meter, or 1,000 millimeters is 1 meter. So a lot of you guys have learned the macroscopic scale. You might know that this would be a decameter. This would be what's called a hectometer. And you can do this with liters too, or grams. And then kilometers. So a lot of us at some point kind of memorized from here to here. The scale below the macroscopic, below what we can see, is called the microscopic. And those are the things that we can see generally with microscopes. And there are names, just like we have centimeter, decimeter, hectometer, all in here. There are names for all of these 1/10 into intervals here, but we don't really use them. We go in chunks of three. So three chunks down, or 1/1000th of a millimeter, or 1/1000000th of a meter, is called a micrometer. So there, that's 1/1000000th of a meter, or there are a million micrometers in 1 meter. So this is our, from here about to here, this is our microscopic scale. And then we have our atomic molecular scale. Okay, and that is the that's the scale of atoms and molecules. And we don't have tools powerful enough to really see these. We can kind of map their surfaces, but we don't have any tool powerful enough to say, see a carbon atom and see the protons and see the neutrons. As some of you may remember, atoms are actually mostly empty space. And so you'd think if we had this tool, we could actually see the nucleus inside, and we just don't have that tool. And so 1,000 units down from a micrometer is a nanometer. So that's right here. And so that is, let's say, that's 1/1000th of a micrometer, 1/1000000th of a millimeter, so 1/1000000000th of a meter, or 1 billion nanometers is a meter. And that's what we call the atomic molecular scale. And then on the flip side of these, we have what we call large scale. Okay, and it is exactly what it sounds like. The large scale is larger things than that macroscopic scale. So for example, the size of a galaxy would be considered large scale. The size, the distance from even like here to the sun, or across a solar system, that would be considered large scale. So the small end of large scale is at the end of that scale that a lot of us have memorized at the kilometer. And then in fact, if you go out 1, 2, 3, so this would be 10 to the sixth, if you're using these like football field lines, this is called a megameter. M-E-G-A. And I'm pointing that out to you. Now, in this it says larger. Anything larger than that is also large scale. But I'm pointing that out to you because a lot of people confuse mega and milli, not in confusing what it is, but when we're abbreviating, when we use a capital M, we mean mega. and we mean 1,000 kilometers or 1,000,000 meters. When we use a lowercase m, we're meaning milli. So just know that there is an actual difference if you use a capital M versus a lowercase m. And we're going to talk about these four scales and what they look like and interact with all of them within the scope of biology.
We can look at anything from these four different scales. So I'm going to give you an example with a cloud at different scales. And I'm going to start with macroscopic here. Macroscopic, remember, is what we can see without needing any tools other than our eyes. So in a cloud, that would be a water drop. We can see water drops. We know when they rain down, we can see them. If we zoom out, and this is what I want you to think about, going in this direction towards larger scale, we need to zoom out. If we can't see something fully without zooming out, that's a good indication that you are in the large scale. So a cloud itself is large scale because you can't see a full cloud without zooming out. Now we've zoomed out by we're all the way down on Earth and the clouds are way up in the atmosphere. But if you've ever been lucky enough to be on an airplane and you've flown through a cloud, you know you can't see that entire cloud when you are in it. It's too big, you have to zoom out. That's large scale. If we're zooming in, going in the other direction, for example, if we had a microscope, we would be able to see water droplets that are smaller than the large water drops that we see, like when we think of a raindrop. Now, you wouldn't be able to see all of these little H2O molecules, but this is the giving you the idea that one little water droplet is made up of millions of water molecules. And then if we zoom in even farther, we get to the atomic molecular scale. And the reason I don't have a zoom in arrow is not because you're not zooming in, you're zooming in even more, but that we can't even see this. So we would get down to say one water molecule, and we don't have the ability to zoom in that far. We can talk later if you're curious about then how do people know that they even exist, right? There are ways we can detect things that we can't see. And so this gives you an example of one object, a cloud, from different scales, even though it's the same thing. And that's what we're going to keep doing this year is we'll zoom into cells, we'll zoom in even further to chemical reactions, we'll zoom out to ecosystems, we'll look at the macroscopic with what we can see moving around an organism, that kind of thing. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask in the comments or ask in class. Have a good day.